3 weeks into the British election campaign, a Nicola Sturgeon has fought her way centre stage. The spotlight squarely on the SNP leader as she unveiled her party's manifesto, an anti-austerity plan launched under the banner Stronger for Scotland. It's a message that's causing some concern south of the border, with claims the SNP would plunge the UK into debt.
Why do you think the English are scared of you?
I don't think they are.
But David Cameron says voters should be scared, as polls show a groundswell of support for the SNP. With polls pointing to a hung parliament, Cameron fears the Scottish Nationalists will form an alliance with Labour, which could topple his Conservatives.
Labour are facing wipeout in Scotland. The only way Ed Miliband can end up in Downing Street is on the coattails of the SNP. And that poses three clear and present dangers to you.
To emphasise the point, the Conservative Party published this poster, showing Nicola Sturgeon treating Ed Miliband as a puppet.
You would have a ransom note, as it were, vote by vote, act by act, decision by decision, for 5 years of a parliament.
As Ed Miliband took the campaign fight to Scotland on Monday, the Labour Party dismissed Cameron's claims as scaremongering and denied any deals were being planned.
Is Labour going to start to form a coalition or to negotiate our budget or our tax rates or the defence of our country with a party which seeks to break up the United Kingdom? And the answer is unequivocally no.
Scotland voted against independence last year, but Sturgeon remains a staunch separatist and had strong words for the Prime Minister as he announced plans for an annual review of how powers granted to Scotland during a referendum will affect the rest of the UK.
Well, then let me say this directly to David Cameron today. We will oppose any effort to undermine the Scottish Parliament.
Fighting words. It could be that David Cameron may be at least one Englishman who is scared of the Scottish leader. Max Foster, CNN London.